These fun videos that have gone viral on social media are not from a dancehall carnival. These are nonsense and made waves in pursuit of practicing licenses in Barara City. They have pitched camp at Mayanja Memorial School since Monday, but things took a dangerous turn when a stampede landed some of them at the health centers.
But it's been very unfortunate, probably due to lack of arrangements and proper planning, that you have to come to one center, you struggle so much to access the facility, there is no guidance, the numbers are so many, others sustain very serious injuries, and of course lots of expenses. You go in a new place and then you stay forever. Those are unacceptable.
On Tuesday morning, very many students collapsed. People got attacks, the asthmatic patients got attacks in that curfew. Even I heard that there are some people who lost even, there is a certain mother who lost even a baby because they had refused to open the gate. So we would first call and show them that there is a patient, there is somebody who has collapsed, so that they can see. And again, they insisted they open it at a later hour.
The nurses and medics blame it on bribery.
So, to me, I think if you have done the exams from them, there is no need of us again telling us to do the interviews in order to access the practicing license and the certificates. If for them they need money from us, they look for other ways of charging that money to us, and we are able to pay instead of making us lose our lives and even wasting time for us.
If you happen to access the facility, the Mayanja Memorial facility, you would tell sister that, you know, here is some milk for you today, I really want to go back. Maybe the people that were doing the exact interview weren't aware, but the people they gave the responsibilities to control the crowd.
The chaos prompted the Mbarara resident city commissioner, together with police detectives, to take action.
But I continued getting complaints. Then I decided to come myself today. That's why I even called the DPC to also come and see for himself, so that we still continue monitoring. One, so that the SOPs are implemented. Two, so that we don't get any insecurity here with this big number of people.
Officials from the Nursing Council, however, say there is no cause for alarm.
Madam, basically,
I just don't want argument. Give me that. So long as you are allowed, because my registrar told me.
There are some people who are asking money from these participants. Some people like you are the ones who cause problems. Yes. You may say I'm for the council when you're asking money from these people. Because I have had an element of money.
In this ongoing exercise, nurses and midwives are required to pay 170,000 shillings to get licenses after interviews.
Not very happy at all. Because these are the same people who sit for us the exams. We sit for them, we sit for the exams. We do even the OSCE interview with them, and they are the ones who come from up there and supervise us. So, to me, I think if you have done the exams from them, there is no need of us again telling us to do the interviews in order to access the practicing license and the certificates.
The exercise is expected to end tomorrow, but those affected want the Nursing Council to revise the model of issuing out licenses, saying some of them have spent years chasing for them. Report by Halson Kagure for the news in Barara.